Breaking news coming your way here on Boston Celtics today. The Celtics have hired their next head coach. It's going to be Ime Udoka, according to ESPN's Adrian Wojnarowski. Udoka going to be replacing Brad Stevens, who is leading this search after taking over as the president of basketball operations after Danny Ainge had stepped down back a couple weeks ago. Woj sent out a tweet saying simply the Celtics finalizing an agreement with Udoka. He was an assistant coach with the Brooklyn Nets this past season. Didn't take long for him to land this head gig after the Nets season had come to an end over the weekend. He was also an assistant coach under Greg Popovich with the San Antonio Spurs from 2012 to 2019. Here's what Woj had to say on Twitter a little bit before 3 o'clock Eastern on this Wednesday. The Boston Celtics are finalizing an agreement to hire Brooklyn Nets assistant Ime Udoka as the franchise's new head coach, sources tell ESPN. He continued on with this report, saying Udoka separated himself quickly in Brad Stevens' search process, including significant support from Celtics players who were impressed with Udoka after working under him with Team USA in the World Championships in 2019. Those Celtics players include Jaylen Brown, Jayson Tatum, and Marcus Smart, who Udoka helped coach in the World Championships back a couple years ago. Celtics fans, it was only a matter of time before Brad Stevens was going to hire his replacement. What's your one-word reaction to the Celtics hiring Udoka? Get your one-word reactions in this comment section down below. For me, I'm just going to go ahead and say solid. I think this is a very solid hire for the Celtics. We put out our Celtics head coaching big board with our top five Celtics head coaching candidates. Udoka was number two in our process. Who was number one? Chauncey Billups. But it looks more and more likely like Billups is going to take the head gig with the Portland Trail Blazers to try to get them back on the right track with Damian Lillard. Little background on Udoka. He's looked at in NBA circles as an up-and-comer. He's only 43 years old. In this search process, Stevens and that front office were looking to diversify the front office and the organization. So that was a big part of the search, but also they wanted a young coach as well. Udoka, only 43 years old. The reason why they valued a younger guy with coaching experience, his ability to kind of gel with the locker room, establish a little bit of a culture, because according to Shams back a couple weeks ago, that culture had kind of fractured this past season, which is a big reason why the Celtics finished the season 500. They underachieved. It was a maddening and inconsistent season for the Celtics, and they went out in the first round of the NBA playoffs. So Celtics get a young head coach in Udoka, who's 43 years old, but has a bevy of experience. But one of the key parts here, Celtics players had raved about him to Brad Stevens, to the front office during the search, because Udoka has familiarity with this roster and the big names on this roster in Tatum, Brown, as well as Smart, because he was an assistant under Popovich during the World Championships 2 years ago back in 2019. So Tatum, Brown, and Smart, according to reports, kind of raved about him, pumped him up, went to Stevens and said, yo, if we're looking for a coach, let's hire Udoka, because we believe he is going to be the right guy to steer us back in that right direction, to get us back to championship contention. That is what Udoka is bringing to the table, and that familiarity with players on this roster certainly bode well with him during this search. Another thing that the Celtics were kind of valuing, and I mentioned this earlier, very, very important for them, according to previous reports, to diversify the entire organization. Stevens, as well as the front office, ownership, especially with everything that's happened socially over the last year and change, Jaylen Brown, a headline player and face of the franchise, he's been very active in the community with social issues. They wanted to diversify this organization and hire a black head coach. That's what Udoka is. He is Nigerian American. He is a coach of color, so the Celtics able to check that off the box as well. From Udoka's standpoint, my goodness, I mean, what a position for him to be in to land this gig. You're talking about a guy who's landing his first head coaching job, and he's able to get his hands on two superstars in Jayson Tatum and Jaylen Brown. Brown is one of the best two-way players across the NBA. Tatum, on the other hand, is bordering on being a top 10 guy. Remember what he did against the Brooklyn Nets in Game 3 of the first round when Kyrie, KD, and James Harden were all healthy? He was the only legitimate potent option offensively for the Celtics, yet he's still able to drop a 50-piece against a team who, if they were healthy, I think the Nets would have competed for an NBA championship this year. So what a gig for Udoka to be able to get this job and be able to coach Tatum and Brown, because it's my belief that if you surround those guys with some more solid pieces, you fortify that front court, you get some good scoring options, and kind of replace Kemba Walker with a player who fits better on this roster, this is a Celtics team that is going to be a problem in the Eastern Conference this upcoming season. Because anytime you have two legitimate wings, and I'm going to go ahead and say that Tatum and Brown are both stars, you have an opportunity to be in that window, be a part of that mix of competing for championships. And for a first-time head coach to land this gig, Udoka, it was probably a no-brainer for him to take this position. Also, Celtics have 17 championships. That's tied for the most in NBA history alongside the Los Angeles Lakers, which is refuted a little bit because they didn't all happen in Los Angeles. You're in a market where the fans really care about the product on the floor, and because of that, ownership is going to be willing to spend to put a competitive roster on the court year in and year out. And also, this is an organization with expectations. And when you look at some of the head coaching openings in the NBA this year, Celtics by far the number one gig on this list, because you have the aforementioned superstars. You're a part of a historic franchise. The resources are always there. And while the pressure is always there, I would admire and embrace that because everybody's always pushing you to succeed. So for Udoka, this is a hell of an opportunity, and I think all of the qualities that he possesses, Brad Stevens really liked it. As far as his playing career, which is another important part of this search, he played in the NBA for 7 years, and when you look back at this search, the Celtics were really valuing guys who had playing experience. Udoka played in the league for 7 years. He also played internationally. He's been around the block for a while. He was an undrafted guy who really had to prove himself and fight his way onto NBA rosters. Spent part of the 2004 season with the Lakers. Spent part of the 2006 season with the Knicks. In between that, he was playing internationally. Spent 2006-2007 with the Portland Trailblazers. Then from 2007 to 2011, he was a member of the San Antonio Spurs and the Sacramento Kings. As far as his coaching career, it's pretty impressive. And the common theme here, he's always been an assistant coach with some winning organizations. Came up under Greg Popovich. I can make the argument Popovich is one of, if not the best coaches in the history of the NBA, and Udoka was able to get tutored by him, guided by him from 2012 to 2019. You can't pick a better coach to learn under the grips than Greg Popovich. And then from 2019 to 2020, a lone season with the Philadelphia 76ers. Yes, the Sixers got eliminated by your Celtics 4-0 in the NBA bubble. That season kind of went down into the tubes for the Sixers. It was a disastrous ending, but that was a winning organization with star players, which is another consistent theme here. Udoka played. He has coached. The experience is there in that regard, but also he has experience coaching stars, and he was coach stars this past season with the Brooklyn Nets with KD, Kyrie, as well as Kevin Durant. So I really love the resume, and I think at the end of the day, this was a no-brainer for Brad Stevens to hire Udoka as the next head coach. This is why you subscribe. Honestly, we were scanning Twitter. We saw that Woj sent out this tweet that the Celtics were hiring Udoka. We got together and we put together a show within 15, 20 minutes. So we're pumping out content very, very quickly when breaking news happens. All reasons for you to subscribe to Celtics Today by Chat Sports as we try to get to 6,000 subscribers. Go to youtube.com/CelticsTV, which is the link at the bottom of your screen, or hit that red subscribe button down below for the latest Boston Celtics news and rumors and breaking news situations like this. To round out today's show, the Celtics have hired Ime Udoka as Brad Stevens' successor. This search led by Stevens didn't really last all that long, and what an offseason it has been for this franchise. The news broke a couple weeks ago that Danny Ainge was going to step down as the president of basketball operations to take his place. Brad Stevens basically left his position as the coach of this franchise to take over the general managing duties. Last Friday, Kemba Walker was traded to the Oklahoma City Thunder in exchange for Al Horford, a familiar face, in addition to Moses Brown, the Celtics sending a first-round pick this year to the Thunder in that deal, and now they have hired their next head coach. It's going to be Ime Udoka. A lot of moving parts in this offseason, and who knows how that's going to kind of play going into the 2021-2022 season, because there is some turnover within this organization. But I'm high on the Celtics because the roster with Tatum and Brown is in a pretty solid place, and then you get your next head coach who people have raved about, and Ime Udoka. He has interviewed for multiple head coaching vacancies over the last couple of seasons, and he kind of possessed all of the qualities that the Celtics were looking for in this search. So before we get out of here, grade the hire of Ime Udoka, and be sure to get your letter grades in the comment section down below. Grade it for us, A, B, C, D, or F.